I'm Raghav Sarda. I'm principal associate in this firm, Lakshmi Kumar Sridhar and Attorneys. So I've been here for more than 7 years. I've been in this field for more than 7 years, and I deal mainly in designs and patent work. So both are different things. Patent relates to the technology, design relates to the final product that comes out and the aesthetic views of the design. So today we are going to talk about design. And so today what we are going to talk about is the industrial designs in India as per the Designs Act 2000. That is the act or the law which governs the design protection in India. We are going to talk about a comparison of patents, designs and copyrights, and then design protection in the field of agriculture. I just got few examples of what things can be protected under from the field of agriculture in the designs part. And I will also have this comparison of patent, designs and copyrights, because designs and copyright, they do have a thin difference between them. There are few things which could have been protected under copyrights also, designs also, but the act or the law provides a distinction on what should be protected under which field. And patents and designs, they are clearly distinct, but still that is something which any person, any manufacturing industry would be dealing with. So I'll also give you a brief difference between patents, designs. And but before that, we'll start with what exactly is design and what exactly the law says for designs in India. So design registration, it protects the aesthetic appeal of a finished article. Like I said, patent tells you the technology, it provides you the technology by which you can manufacture any article. But the designs gives you, protects the final article, how the article looks. For example, if you have this glass or if you have this chair, how the chair looks, the shape of the chair, the complete pattern on the chair, that is something which will be protected under the design protection. And it is completely, it talks about the aesthetic appeal, it protects something which you see. Aesthetic appeal of any article is something which can be seen by your eyes. Design is only and only something which is visible to a person's eyes. The design will be on an article, it will be on the outside part of an article so that you can see it. You can feel difference between two different articles. You can feel the difference between two different designs on different articles. So it only talks about the aesthetic appeal of a finished article. The definition of design that is provided under the Act is in the section 2D of the Act. And as per section 2D, the design means only the feature of shape. So now what is this feature of shape? I have to click on this. Hyperlink pe click karna. Can I do this? So here, if you can see, there are few examples on in these designs. What you can protect is the shape or the shape of the article. So for example, this is an ironing machine. So you see it has a particular shape, the handle, it has got this curve, the base, there are these curves here. So this is what the shape of an article is. And the design, that protection that you will get for this ironing machine is this whole shape. Similarly for this bag, the way it has been cut, this vase, the way it has been cut, all these things, they have a distinct shape. You can have vases of various shapes, various designs. So each different shape, each different design, we can get you a different design protection. Similarly, these two, they are the same article, but they have different shape, they have different designs. So for both of them, you can get a different design protection. Similarly here, this toothbrush, you can see, you would have seen other toothbrushes, it has got this some angle, it is angled at this part, there are some surface configurations over this. So all these things, if you have to protect, if you have an article which has all these different shapes, configurations, you can protect them under design protection. How they were built would again come under the patent, but what they finally look like is what comes under the design protection. Back to the slide. So the next thing is configuration. What is configuration? So configuration, So here again, we had seen that this was the design, this was the shape. This was again the shape of the toothbrush. What is configuration is this thing on the toothbrush, that grip kind of thing, that dotted grips which are on the toothbrush. Configuration could be again something like this, this difference in pattern. So this is configuration. So for a same article, you can say that what you want to claim is the design of the whole article and the configuration of the whole article. So you would tell the patent office that the novelty or the new thing in my design lies in the complete shape as well as the configuration. So whenever you are going to protect design, you have to see what you want to protect. Do you want to protect only the shape, or do you want to protect the configuration? So these are two things that we can have in the same sheet. Here again, this is the whole shape of the phone, whereas these again will provide you something which will come under configuration. So for the same article, you'll have you'll have to mention your novelty resides not only in the shape but also in the configuration. However, if for these two, three different phones, you can say the novelty or the new part might lie in the shape as such and not the whole configuration, because these things are almost same. But what differs is it has a curve. In fact, this also has a curve, but if it was a slight straight phone, you could have said that there was a difference in the shape. So all these things matter, because when you look at these two things, any person who looks at them will say, yes, they differ. There is as such no test on finding out whether two designs differ or not. The only test is by the way of eyes. Whenever you go to court for any infringement or anything, whenever you go to the court asking them, saying that you had a design protection and somebody else is manufacturing that article with the same design, the only way the court can judge whether they are same or not is by putting your design and that other person's design side to side, and then see how do they look. Do they look similar? Do they look different? It is only based on the person's eyes, and that is why we say design is for the aesthetic appeal of an article. Back to the slide. So the next thing is pattern. What is a pattern? You can have a design protection for a pattern also. So pattern is something like this. If you see, this whole thing repeats in this whole article, in this whole square again. This thing repeats in the whole article. These are small patterns which are repeating across the whole fiber. So pattern is something that you have a small drawing which keeps on repeating on the whole cloth. So if you see, if you go to market, this thing, this pattern mainly is, generally it is for textile fabric industries, because they provide, they manufacture this fabric which have the same pattern across. So pattern is something, if you have an artistic design which keeps on repeating on the same article, which keeps on repeating on the same fabric, then it will come something, then it will come under as the pattern protection. So although this might not come as a pattern, this would come, but this would be something which would be a pattern. If you go back here, there is as such no repetition of any pattern here in any of these designs, in any of these products. But
if somebody make it say rectangular and put some unnecessary force at that particular shape and say that it is my,
now if it looks different, see, if somebody makes it rectangular, what was the appeal? Corners are there, right? And the sharp edges are there instead of round. So if you see, both the designs would look different. Both the phones would look different from each other, right? So this is something which the person would have come afterwards, because generally we used to have the sharp edged phones. Then people came up with this. So this was a new design, because it gave a new look. So any design which gives you a new look can be protected. Although, when they are being protected, the patent office again would keep the two things side by side and try to judge whether if I look at, say, this phone and this phone, do they look different? It's only the size. So here you might not get the patent protection, design protection. Because when you're going to protect design, you're not going to say that what size it is. You're going to provide this diagram, the photograph of this and the photograph of this. They will say they are same. Even for this thing, the design office might say, what is the difference? This is same, the only difference is this. So if somebody wants to protect specifically this and this whole thing, then he might get a design protection, but that would be for the configuration. He might not get a protection for the shape as such. He might get a protection only for configuration of this whole article. So whenever he would go to court, right? So he can only sue a person for this thing, for the configuration of this, not for the shape of the whole design. And since you already have a phone protection which has this design, he would be infringing you also, because your basic shape will be in his phone. Right? So he'll have to pay royalty to you also. So if you had this design, you would be protected. He might get some other protection, he might not get. But even if he gets, he might be asked to pay royalty to you, because you had the basic shape which had this phone, this round edges. Back to slide. So the next thing is ornament. So ornament, you can just... So for ornament, these are the things. So the design, the jewelry industry, the different designs on the bangle. You can see there are two different rings. They both have different designs. So you might get a design protection for this design, and you say that it is the ornamentation. That what you are trying to protect here is the ornamentation. You can, for this, you might even try to claim shape and configuration, but ornamentation would be the main thing here that you're trying to protect. Here you might not be able to protect the shape as such, because most of the necklaces would have a similar shape. But the ornamentation, the way these beads have been placed and all these things, they will give a new ornamentation feeling. If you put two necklaces together, the shape might come out something like this. But the final inside this ornamental design, that would differ. So for jewelry industry, what they try to protect is mainly the ornamentation. You can have ornamentation, you might try to protect ornamentation for this. Somebody might try to protect ornamentation for this. It would be really difficult, but you can try. But yes, at least for this thing, you would get shape and configuration. For this, you might not get the shape as such. You might not get a protection for shape, because the patent office would say that any necklace would have a similar shape. Any ring would have this similar shape, right? But what the new thing would be, the ornament which is with it, the ornamental design, or this different design would be there. You can try and protect only because of this, maybe this tilt. That is something you can try to protect. So for designs, you, whenever you think of protecting the design or going for design protection, what you have to say is, does it look like a normal article in that particular design? You would not compare say the design of a mobile phone with the design of a bag. You would compare the design of a mobile phone with a mobile phone, an electronic device with an electronic device. Okay, and why do you do that? That I'll tell you in the next slide. But yes, whenever you're going to protect your design, you have to look what all differences are there with respect to previous known thing. Does it look different? Does it appeal to a person's eye? If you show it to your customer, will he say that, okay, this is something new, this is something which looks good to my eye? If that is the case, you should go for a design protection, and you can get a design protection for that case. Then composition of lines is something of the way the lines are provided. how the lines are drawn on some article. There I could not find very good examples for composition of lines, so I have not put them here. But composition of lines mainly show about, they are different from ornamentation, they are different from pattern. They say how to design two lines are made on the article. So for example, if there were some lines here, you could have gone for the composition of lines, how you see few lines on the article. So that comes under the composition of lines, and colors is the color combination.
Composition of the line is, the chair is there in front of the black one. These lines have, they can be...
I would go more for surface protection here, because they show the features of shape and the configuration, how the sheet is there. You can try protect for composition of lines also, but that is something which patent office generally does not easily give. Because this is something, if you clearly see, it would come how the surface is configured, how the surface pattern is there on the surface of the article. So, now coming to colors, color is how the color configuration of the article is. Now generally, if you have a design, say you have this design, this is a capsule and this is also a capsule. The main difference that you would see is in the color combination. It is this red, yellow, this is blue, yellow. So if you want to protect a capsule, everybody knows the capsule will have this shape. What you can go for there is the color composition, and the exactly color combination that you would say that you want to protect the color combination in which you have shown the capsule. However, the only point about color combination is that if you claim it in one color combination, this article, then if anybody manufactures this article, he would not be infringing you, because this would be limited to a color. Whereas if you file a protection for a black and white design, or you do not say any color, you just provide dotted lines. So for example, if you provide this kind of image to the patent office, what it would mean is that irrespective of whatever color the syringe is being manufactured, the person will be infringing you. He would be infringing you. Whereas if you go for something like this and say you want to protect the color, the person would infringe you only if he has this exact color combination with the blue base, this blue buttons here. So that's why generally we suggest our clients not to go for color combination until and unless color combination is very necessary for them. Say for example, he would not have got any design protection here if he had not gone for color protection, color combination. He could have tried to protect the configuration as such if they look different, but chances are very less. Any person would say, what is the original, because what is the originality in this thing? Any capsule will have to be in this shape. There will have to be generally two parts, because that is how the capsule was made, and you had to put the material in here. So there are no differences as such. Color combination is something new. So that is also something which you can protect. And a design should be applied to any article. So design was the whole thing, the shape, the configuration, the pattern, the ornament, the colors. But article is the final product on which you are going to apply the design. So the capsule was the article there, and the design was the color combination. The ironing machine was the article, the whole shape of the, and the configuration of the, on that, in which the ironing machine was manufactured, was the design. So any design has to be applied to an article. You cannot just go and say that I'll have a curve, I will have a device which will have some curvature. You'll have to mention what the device is going to be, what the article is going to be. Is it going to be a magazine, or is it going to be an electronic device, something like a mobile phone? So, and why is that necessary? Because if you have claimed that your design is applied to a particular article or to a particular category of product, then any person who applies design to that particular category of product or to that category of article, only he will be infringing you. So for example, you have a teddy bear shaped chocolate. You manufacture that and you want to protect it. You protect it under foodstuff, this class of foodstuffs which protect candies and chocolates. that will be your article. You will protect under that range of articles, that class of articles. And if somebody later on, say Nataraj comes up and produces an eraser which was also of the same shape as that of your chocolate, it produces a teddy bear shaped eraser, then he would, that company that might not be infringing your product, because it would be a completely different article. It would be an eraser. It would not be the chocolate or a foodstuff like you are protected. So that is a way by which the patent office encourages people to file. First find out in what field are they going to use the design, in what is going to be their manufacturing line, who are going to be their competitors, and then they protect their designs in all those different articles. And it also does not stop anybody from claiming a design, because if it did not restricted it a design protection to a different article, then the first person to have filed a design registration for any article having a teddy bear shape, he would have stopped the use of the teddy bear shape in any industry. You would not have stuffed toys, you would not have chocolates, you would not have eraser, you would not have show pieces. So just to do that, they have this restriction that a design, not only the design, but you also have to mention the article. Now the article, the design has to be applied to an article, whether in two-dimensional or three-dimensional or in both forms, by an industrial process or means, whether manual, mechanical, or chemical, separated or combined. So it should be done using industrial process or means. And why they do it? Because they want to keep it separate from copyright also. You do not just take up a brush and paint a Ganeshji's photo on a paper and say it is my design and the article is paper. No, that is something which will come under copyright protection, and for that they also have something later on. But yes, the design is something which can be applied to an article by an industrial process or means. It should not be that you just let it grow. You take up a plant and you just let it grow on some, say, a stick and say it, a new design has come up. No. The article, the design has to be brought out to you, brought out by you on that article using some industrial process or means. And which in the finished article appealed to and are judged solely by the eye, that is visible during the course of use or operation of the article. So for example, you take up a water bottle. What you can do is you have all, you would have seen different water bottles of different shapes. See, so you can have a design protection for them. But if you try to bring out some shape inside the water bottle, you make some groove inside the water bottle and try to protect it, saying that it has a new design, you might not get a protection, because nobody would actually ever be able to see that design. You would only see something which is outside on the bottle, not something on the inside of the bottle. So you would not get a protection for that. You would get a protection for something which is visible to you. So now what it does not include as such is any mode of principle. Of construction or any mode of principle of construction or anything which in substance a mere mechanical device. So you cannot claim anything when you are claiming a design. You cannot say that I want to claim also the mode of principle of the construction on which the design on the article was manufactured, using the principle of construction by which the article was manufactured. Or for example, you cannot claim something which is mode of construction or in which in substance is a mere mechanical device. For example, if you have a screw, right? Now the screw has those grooves. Those are because of a particular reason. If you do not have those screws on there, you would not be able to use it for screwing up any two things. So screwing up any two things together. So there you cannot have a design for those grooves which are on screws or on the nails, because they are there for a specific reason. They are there for a specific purpose, and it provides the mechanical, it comes up something which would be known as a mere mechanical device. Because if you do not have those particular screws at those particular angles, those grooves at those particular angles, you would not be able to use it for making up the furniture. You would not be able to use it as a nail. So that's why the only design was there because of some functionality which it which the screws provided some particular functionality to that, and because of that you cannot claim that functionality, you cannot claim the device. The design also cannot include any trademark, it cannot include any property mark, or it cannot include anything, any artistic work which is defined under Copyright Act. So like I told you, if M.F. Hussain someday paints up a painting, come up with a painting, a Lord Ganesha's painting on a paper, that is something which is defined under the Copyright Act as an artistic work. You cannot protect it. Whereas if you take up Lord Ganesha's figure and you manufacture a showpiece using it, you manufacture an eraser using that, that you can protect, because that would something which is not protected under Copyright Act as such. That would, for that you would have used some industrial way for manufacturing the idol, for manufacturing the eraser or the showpiece. The article was there, the article would be the eraser or the showpiece. So since it qualifies there, therefore it would, and also it is not an artistic work under Copyright Act as such, therefore you can have a design protection over that. Now this is an illustrative list of what is not a design. This is as such not given in the Act, but there is something called as Manual of Designs, Patent Practice and Procedure, which was published by the Patent Office. So they have given a list of few examples where they say that you cannot get a design protection. So you cannot get a design protection for a book jacket, calendars, certificates, forms and documents. This would come under copyright protect. That's something like an article under, or artistic protection under Copyright Act. Dress making patterns, greeting cards, leaflets, maps and plan cards, postcards, stamps and medals, painting, sculpture, drawings, any work of architecture, any building or structure having an artistic character or design. All this will come under Copyright Act. Any work of artistic craftsmanship, all this work will come under Copyright Act. So you cannot have a protection, a design protection for these. Now what is an article? Article is defined as an article of manufacture and any substance. It can be artificial or partly artificial and partly natural. So it cannot be completely natural. There has to be some artificial thing in the article. And then N includes any part of an article capable of being made and sold separately. So if you have anything which you cannot, I cannot think of an example here, but here suppose if you take this chair, you might not, somebody would not manufacture the backrest separately, the legs separately and the support separately. They would manufacture the whole chair and sell it. So whenever you go to a market, you would not ask somebody to provide you the backrest of a chair. You would ask them for a chair. That is something which will be made and sold separately. So you will get a design protection for the chair itself, the design, the shape of the chair, and not the shape or design of only the backrest or the handle. That is something which you generally would not manufacture. You can manufacture, but you will not sell separately, because nobody would go to a market to buy just the backrest of a chair. So that is something which will not be protected under, which will not be counted as an article, and therefore any new shape of just the backrest, if you have to protect it, you'll have to protect the whole chair as an article and not just the backrest. Whereas if you have a car, so for a, in a vehicle or in a car, you would see there are a lot of things. You can sell the headlights separately. People can go and buy the headlights separately. People can go and buy the bonnet part separately. Bumpers you can buy separately. So for them, you can have different design protection. You can have a design protection for the whole car as such, how the car looks. You can have a design protection for how the headlight looks. You can have a design protection for how the bumper looks. So you can have different design protections for those different articles. But in something like in the chair, you cannot have a design protection for a separate backrest, because nobody would go to a market and buy it separately. So criteria for a registration is that a design can be protected if it is new or original. New is something which you had not seen before. Original is like we talked about the mobile phone. Like in the case of mobile phone, somebody had the edged, the sharp-edged phone, and somebody had the curved phone. So if the mobile phone, the whole design of the mobile phone as such is new, but is it also original? The only change was the sharp edge. From sharp edge, you came up with the curve. So when somebody came up from the sharp edge to the curve, was it an original idea? Was it obvious for a person to go from sharp edge to curved edge or not? That is something which the patent office would try and find out. It will say, okay, the mobile phone ka shape as such is not new, because any mobile phone is generally a rectangular shaped phone. But the originality in idea was there, and the originality in idea was there of was from going to sharp edge to curved edge, which gave the whole phone a new look. So that is something which would come. It will not test only for new, for the design being new, it would also check it for originality. It should be distinguishable from the known designs. It should be capable of being applied to an article, and it should appeal to and are judged solely by the eye. And again, so for example, you have a, you go to our old architectural buildings, Red Fort, it would have many carvings would be there. Now somebody tries to pick up that carving and put it on an article. So the patent office might object, the court might object that saying that, okay, it was applied to an architectural building and you have and what you have done is that you have put it on some other stuffed toy or something else. But was it original? Was taking that design from there and putting it on the article, does that make the article completely different or not? That is something the patent office can object to. It might fight up, although there are chances the design would get get granted, because it is on a completely different article. To do that and thinking of getting that carvings on the design on the complete new article and giving it a, would give the article a new feel, would make the article new or original as compared to the other known articles. But there again, somebody might object, and it would be up to the court to see whether it is distinguishable from the new design and whether it is original as such, because everybody would have seen those designs in open. And it should appeal to and judged solely by the eye. So like I said, there is as such no test for finding out whether a design is new or not, whether a design is original or not. You just have to put that design, the new design, or the that design along with the known designs to differentiate how does it look to you, does it appeal to your eye or not. And then only you can judge whether it is new or not. Now to be eligible for registration of a design should not be previously published. इसमें वो ऑप्शन होगा ना, या तो ऑप्शन बार बार कनेक्ट करने की कोशिश कर रहा होगा. एक मिनट रुको, बस अब हो जाएगा. एयरप्लेन मोड कर दिया ना, वो एयरप्लेन मोड ऑन कर दिया, तो आई गेस इट वुड स्टॉप इट नाउ. सो अ डिजाइन शुड नॉट be previously published or used in any country before the priority date for registration. It should not comprise obscene or scandalous matter and be contrary to public order or morality. Now what is this priority date? Priority date is the date when the application was first filed. So suppose you come up with a, yes?
Inside you are saying there is no prior art search.
There is a prior art search. You can do your prior art search, even the patent office. You can file a request with the patent office. You can file your design with the patent office and ask them to search, let you know whether any previous design has been protected for that or not.
What is the difference between patent and design filing
system? That I'll just come up in next few slides. What is the difference? But as such, even for patent office, when you have to file a patent, the prior art search has to be done by you. The patent office as such does not do a prior art search before you file the application. It will do a prior art search only once you have filed it. So for design also, they will do the prior art search only once you have filed the design. However, in design office, they also have this provision that before filing application, you first have to submit a design and ask them whether there has been any design previously registered for the same thing or not. And they will let you know. That is a different, but it would not be a complete prior art search, because they might not search outside the database. So if you see, the design should not have been previously published or used in any country. So if it was not registered, but somebody might have published it on net. Somebody might have published it on in a magazine. So there are those are the chances, and for that you yourself will have to do the prior art search. Nobody else can do the prior art search. So that prior art search, I would always suggest you should do. Even if you are not going for a design protection, you should anyways check for a search whether somebody has design registration over that or not. Because if you manufacture an article with a particular design which somebody has already protected, you would be infringing that person. So that search should always be done, even if you are filing or not.
One more question. It is not territory-based.
No, the protection is territory-based, but the prior art can be from any country. Even in patent, the prior art can be from anywhere in the world. It is for global. Novelty inventive step, that would be based on the global basis. If it was published, used, known anywhere in the world, it would serve as a prior art. Similar case is here. So that's why company, when it files a design or patent protection in one country, they go in other countries so that nobody else can use the same. You had a question? I think you had a question? Okay, sorry. So that's the thing. So those are the similarities in patents and designs. And I think in any copyright, in any IPR protection, those things would be valid. So for the priority date, telling you is that priority date is the first date on which any design was filed. So it could have been if you had filed the design for the first time in India, the priority date would be the date in which it was filed in India. And if you had filed it first in any other country, then the priority date would be the date on which you had filed it in any other country. Now, I think you had a session on PCT application, so you would all need to know about the priority country and the convention applications. So a similar law works here, all the other timelines are different. So for PCT, you had 12 months time for filing in PCT from the initial filing, and then 30 months from the initial date on filing in other convention countries. In designs, you have only a time period of 6 months. So we'll see the thing. Now, who can apply for registration of a design? Any person or their legal representative or the signee can apply separately or jointly for the registration of design, similar to a patent thing. The term person includes firm, partnership, and body corporate. An application can also be filed through an agent, in which case a power of attorney should be filed. So these are similar to the patent protection that you would have studied already. Now, the priority claim is applicants from countries member of conventions to which India is a party, such as Paris Convention, can also claim priority from a convention application if the Indian application is filed within 6 months from the date of the convention application. And vice versa is also true. So if you filed a design application in US or in OHIM, which is the European part, if you file a design application there, then you have to file the design application in India within 6 months if you want to claim the same priority. If you fail to file within 6 months, then you cannot claim priority. And similarly, if you have a design protection in India, then if you have to go out, you have to file the design protection in any other country within 6 months. So instead of the 12 month and the 30 months time that you had there in patent, you have only 6 months time. And that is because design protection as such, the design office works faster than the patent office. They have to give the design, they have to decide about design registration within 6 to 9 months. That is the general time period. The whole examination process generally completes within 6 months from the date of filing. You get the office action within 2-3 months you get the office action, and you have to reply within the next 2-3 months. That is, you have to reply to the office action within 6 months from the filing date. So that's how the design office works, so that you can have the design protection between 9 to 12 months. Because design is something different from patent. For patent, there's a technology. Technology remains for 20 years. The design might or might not remain after 2-3 years. So a person will have use of the design protection only if he gets the design protection within 6-7 months or within 9 months. So that's why the design office also works fast, and it works really fast as compared to the patent office in all the countries. Piracy of registered design, that is the main thing, and that is why people file their design protection, because they want to capture somebody who is infringing their right. So you see, what the section 22 says that a copyright in a registered design gives the protector the exclusive right to apply the design to any article in any class in which the design is registered. So you would notice this term, that a copyright in a registered design. So you do not get a design application. So there is nothing like a design application and a design as such. There is a design application and a registered design. And in registered design, you get a copyright protection. You would have heard about Apple, Samsung cases in US. So there they get design patent. There they have something called as design patent. In India, we only have a design. We do not call it design patent. We call it a design, and we say that you get a copyright in a design, because design again works on the artistic feature. It again works on the aesthetic appeal, which was similar to the copyright. So here you have a copyright as such in a registered design, but this copyright is not governed by the Copyright Act. This is governed by the Design Act. So don't get confused by the term copyright. If anybody says that I have a copyright in a registered design, this means he has a registered design. He has got a design granted by the patent office. But the technical or the legal term that is used is that you get a copyright in a registered design. So during the existence of copyright in any design, it shall not be lawful for any person for the purpose of sale to apply or cause to be applied to any article in any class of articles. So for example, like I told you that whenever you have to file a design, it has to be for an article, and it has to be filed in a particular class. Class rules the category of article, of similar articles. So for example, there is as such no different, you cannot, whenever you have to file that mobile phone, you will not say that the design is for a mobile phone or a tablet. You will say it is for an electronic device, which governs the class, which comes under the class. The electronic device as such will be the class. And in that class, what all you can protect are different articles. The articles could be the laptop, it could be a tablet, it could be a mobile device. So if you have a design, if you filed for a design in this class which governs electronic device, and although you had pasted the photograph of a mobile phone, if somebody manufactures the same design on a tab, and you are able to prove that that article also comes in the same class in which you had filed for the protection, then that person would be infringing you. So it will not, you will not be mentioning anywhere, anytime in the design that it is for a mobile phone. You will be mentioning that it is for an electronic device. And so therefore, that's how, and you would also be mentioning the class. Whenever you have to file a design, you have to mention the particular category of products, which is the class. That in this category of products, I want to have my design protection. So you mention the class which governs the category of product, and in that category of product there can be different product, each product being an article. Okay, so during the existence of copyright in any design, so for the purpose of sale to apply or cause to be applied, it's not only apply, so you could be the manufacturer itself, or you could be an exporter who asks a manufacturing unit to manufacture article which have a design which was already registered. So it is not only, if you have a design, you would not be only capturing the manufacturing unit, which could be a small unit, you might not even get anything from him. But you would also be able to capture the person who placed the order with him of that particular article having that particular design, because he asked him to manufacture that article of that particular design. You could be an exporter. You can capture an exporter if he asks some manufacturing unit to manufacture the same article having the particular design which was already registered. So it is not only the person who applies, but also who caused to be applied to any article in any class of articles in which the design is registered. The design or any fraudulent or obvious imitation thereof, except with the license or written consent of the registered proprietor, or to do anything with a view to enable the design to be so applied. So it is not only the design, but it is only any also fraudulent or obvious imitation thereof. So for example, like we talked in that case there was this ironing machine. If you look at the ironing machine, there was particular shape and configuration. If somebody changed only some angle of the grip, which as such does not allow him to get a different design protection, then the court would say that yes, they are all they are same, although the grip of the angle of the handle of your ironing machine, which you protected, it was say 40 degree. Now somebody manufactures it with 60 degree. The court would say it is not exactly same, but it seems to be an obvious imitation of the design. Then also, the court with the person would be infringing you, because he knew that your design exists, and he applied the design to an article, or he asked somebody to apply that design on an article, or he in fact enabled that somebody to apply the design to an article for the purpose of sale. So he did that knowing that there was a design, and he did not take a license from you, he did not get a written consent from you, so he would be infringing your design. To import for the purposes of sale without the consent of the registered proprietor any article belonging to the class in which the design has been registered. So it is not only an Indian manufacturer. Say somebody goes to China, you have a design protection in India, somebody goes to China or any other country, he asks a unit there to manufacture the device, the article, and imports it in India, he would be infringing your right. So similar to patents, for sale, for import, for export, when you say it's cost to be applied, you even capture the export part. So all these things are protected. If anybody does any of these actions, he will be infringing you. He will be caught for piracy of the copyright in your design. And this is also a very important part here, that knowing that the design or any fraudulent or obvious imitation thereof has been applied to any article in any class of articles in which the design is registered without the consent of the registered proprietor, to publish or expose a cause to be published or exposed for sale that article. So you come to know of an article, of a design in a particular article, you tell somebody, why don't you manufacture this article? And then you published a brochure having those articles with the particular design. Even if you do that, you would be infringing, you would be caught for piracy of the copyright and designs, because you knew when you published, you did not sell the article, you did not ask somebody to manufacture that, you did not import it, but in your brochure, in your sale brochure, you published the copy of that article. You allowed people to come to know about the article through your brochure, that then, and you knew that the design or the article, they have been protected under design protection, and the person that he is doing an act of piracy. So if you knew that the design is not his, the article and the design, his actions are amounting to piracy of a copyright, and still you publish the design or that article in your magazine, in your brochure, then you would be again liable for damages. So that is also something important, that whenever, this is more for the sale manufacturing industry, for the publication house, to be conscious before manufacturing or publishing any kind of article, any kind of sale promotions. Now, if any person acts in contravention of this action, he shall be liable for every contravention. These are the damages and the punishments which the act has clearly defined would be given. So he will be asked to pay to the registered proprietor of the design a sum not exceeding 25,000 rupees recoverable as a contract debt. This is a small amount, I know, but still. If the proprietor elects to bring a suit for the recovery of damages for any such contravention and for inaction against a repetition thereof, to pay such damages as may be awarded and be restrained by injunction accordingly. So if you are able to prove that because of his act, when he started selling article having the same design as yours, he came up as a big competitor to you, he ate up a lot of market share of yours, and because of that you suffered a lot, you had manufactured pieces which you were not able to sell, you suffered, your business suffered, then you can ask the court to pay damages. So apart from this sum of 25,000, you can also ask for damages, or you can ask for an injunction. The injunction would be that you can ask the court to seize all his articles, all his manufacturing things. You can stop his manufacturing unit from manufacturing those articles, all the articles that he has sold, or all the articles that he has manufactured and shipped into different to different shops, he would be asked to recall them. All the goods will be seized, or he might be asked for to destroy those. So all these are different remedies that you can get up, or you can simply ask for damages and allow him to sell the things. Then, provided that the total sum recoverable in respect of any one design under clause A shall not exceed 50,000 rupees, provided further that no suit or any other proceedings for relief shall be instituted in any court below the court of district judge. So district judge is the minimum court, is the first court where you have to go. You cannot go to any court before that. So, and patent office as such, like in case of patent, the office will not give you damages. It will not tell anybody to stop. It will not pass any injunction order. It will have to be in the court of law. Now, in any suit or other proceedings for relief, every ground on which the registration of design may be cancelled under section 19 shall be available as a ground of defense. So if you sue somebody for infringing your design, for piracy of a design, what he can argue back is that your design as such should not have been even granted. And the reasons, the grounds for that could be the ones we had studied before, that the design is not new or original, or it was known, it was published somewhere before your priority date. So those grounds stand still. He can use any of those grounds as a defense and say that your design is not valid and he should hence not be asked to pay for any damages. Notwithstanding anything contained in the second proviso, where any ground on which the registration of a design may be cancelled under section 19 has been failed off as a ground of defense under in any suit or other proceeding for relief under subsection 2, the suit or such other proceeding shall be transferred by the court in which the suit or such other proceeding is pending to the High Court for decision. So if you had filed a suit of infringement in the district court and somebody wants to take this ground to invalid your registered design, then the matter should go up to High Court. The High Court will then take up both the matters. They will first decide on the validity of a design. If they find it valid, then they would go for your infringement suit. If not, then your infringement suit also gets cancelled. But if anybody tries to file a counter suit against you for defense, saying that your design is invalid, then he will proceed to the High Court. Now, when the court makes a decree in a suit, it shall send a copy of the decree to the controller, who shall cause an entry thereof to be made in the register of design. So this order or this decree could be either invalidity of a design, or it could be an injunction against the person against whom you had filed the case, or an order of the damages. So the controller keeps a track of all the things. He keeps a track of whether your design has been challenged in the court of law, whether the court found out the design to be invalid or not. If it was found to be valid, then was the other person found out to be guilty of infringing your design, of committing an act of piracy on your copyright? And if yes, then what were the damages? All these things will be again be controlled, taken care of by the controller. He will maintain all the records, because there could be chances then that there are later on cases, somebody else also files a case against you. So all this evidence can again be used up by the court in those cases, in further actions. Okay, claiming priority. So this is similar to what Patent Act says. A design application from a convention country shall be filed in India within 6 months from the priority date. Along with the application for registration of designs, following documents have to be submitted. You have to submit a certified copy of your priority document, which acts as a proof showing that yes, you had filed an application in another country and that 6 months have not exceeded from that priority date. You have to submit a certified copy of assignment. If applicant in India is different, so for example, in US or in any other in the priority country, you had filed the application in the name of applicant A, and when you come to India, you want to file it in the name of applicant A or A and B, then you have to show an assignment. You have to submit an assignment document also, showing that the current applicant in India had a right over, has a right over the design, and the original applicant has given him the right. Because otherwise, any person, if he sees any design being filed outside India, and he should not come up in India and claiming the priority, even if he does not have a right over the article. So a proper certified copy of assignment, or even the original assignment, has to be submitted. And English translation if required. The English translation would generally be for the certified copy of priority document. Because if you had filed it in a country in which English was not the primary language in which the design application was filed, then patent office would not understand whether the design application was for the same document, for the same design or not, what was the priority date, and whether all the other things, all the related bibliographic data would also not be available to the design office. So it needs the same to be provided as a part of an English translation. And likewise, an application originating from India may be filed in other convention countries within 6 months from the date of filing. Now, along with the application, so I have told you that what has to be submitted along with the application, but in the application as such, what you have to submit is the diagrams or the views of the design. So for instance, if you have this chair, you will have to give different views, like the top view, how the chair looks from the top, how the chair looks from the right side, how the chair looks from the left side, how the chair looks from the back, how the chair, you also have to give a perspective view, a 3D view from, say, this angle from which I am looking at the chair, a perspective view from this angle from the back end side, how the chair looks from the bottom if somebody tries to look at the chair, how it looks. So that, because whenever somebody has to judge whether two designs are looking similar or not, they will never be able to judge it by looking at it from one angle. They will have to look at the design holistically, they will have to look at the designs at all the angles, and that's why views from all possible angles have to be provided along with the design application. They should be clear enough for the patent office to judge. If you want to protect these lines on the chair, they should be visible in the design. If they are not visible, then you cannot say that in your configuration or in your surface pattern, you had these designs and anybody should not be allowed. So the design should be clear, all the possible views have to be given, otherwise there are no good chances of catching somebody else. Term of design registration, very small. A design is granted for 10 years, but again, it is justified because generally the designs, they do not last for that long. If somebody comes up with a textile or with a fabric, the designers say that they do not even last for a single season of a wedding. So all these things, so generally that's why a design is granted for 10 years. Term of the design can be extendable for a second period of 5 years from the expiration of the original 10 years. So suppose after 9 years, you think that your design is still useful, your design is still in market, you are still manufacturing it, there is a big market for your design and the article, then you can ask the patent office to provide you an extension for further 5 years. You have to pay some extension fees, but that has to be paid before the expiration of the 10 years. And again, unlike patent, there are no annuity fees in designs. You pay the application fee, you get the design granted, then for the next 10 years, you do not have to pay anything. The only time you would be asked to pay anything again would be when you would be making this request for an extension of 5 years. So that is something which is good in India, because in many countries, the design protection is only for 10 years. There are no provision for extension. But in India, at least, you have a provision of extending the design for 5 more years. And in case of claiming the priority, the original duration is 10 years from the priority date. So your priority date gets shifted back by 6 months or whatever months before which you had filed the application. Strategy for design protection, as such, these are again almost similar to what somebody would use in a patent protection. First to file rule is applicable. Whoever files the design first, he gets a right. If two or more applications relating to an identical or a similar design are filed on different dates, the first application will be considered for registration of design. After publication in the official gazette on payment of prescribed fees, all registration designs are open for public inspection. Yes, that is one thing. So generally, in patent, you would have studied that a patent gets published after 18 months from the filing. Design gets only published if it is granted. So if your design is not granted, patent office somehow finds some technical or legal flaw in that, it will not even publish your design. So that is again to protect the person's work. If you are not granting him the design, so at least not make it public. So that is what the patent office considers. And also, that's why they don't even publish the design before it gets granted, because the patent office as such does not know whether the design would be granted or not. And also, since it generally takes about 6 to 9 months, or sometimes at max I say 12 months is what I have seen at max generally. If a patent has to be granted, it generally gets granted within 9 to 12 months. So if that is the time, then after that it will be open to public, and then you can start filing cases against whoever you want. Because again, that
somebody can oppose.
So they oppose after the design gets granted. Like I told you, they give a time period of, I think, 3 months is something like that. So they give you that time period, you can oppose the application. But as such, it is like in patent, you have this pre-grant and post-grant opposition, completely different thing. As such, in designs, there is no such time period. I think you can oppose it for the whole life cycle also. I'll just check that. I might have even it in the future, in my following slides. But yes, you can oppose it for the whole cycle, the 10 years, because before it got granted, you had not seen it, so you could never have opposed it. And the reason they do not publish it before getting granted is, again, like I told you, they want to respect the person's work. If you are not granting it, let's not even publish it. The person, when he filed the application, he might have found out after the filing the application that his design looked similar to somebody else's design. So thereafter, he might want to work on it and come up with a new design which was different. And so he might file a new design protection, a new design application. So that's why they do not publish the design if it is not granted.
Is there any mechanism like a PCT?
No, you have to file convention application. See, because you have to do the things within 6 months. If you start filing so many papers and all in all, you would be involved only in filing paper and 6 months, whenever you would not know when they get over. It's a small time. And that 6 months again is kept because the time period of 10 years starts from the initial 6 months time period. And also design market is small. The designs change very easily. So that's why they have not kept such things. There are chances, there are talks of coming up with a common system, but then again the time period would be like 1 month. In 1 month you have to file within the other PCT or some other country. If this anyways come out, everything will have to be taken care of within 6 months. So the things will have to be fast. So it finally turn out to be a problem for the applicant also. And they, instead of going to some other general body and then going into national phase, they might directly want to go into the national phase. So I think this answers to one of the questions which was asked before, that there would be many designs which are not protected and therefore would not be part of any database maintained by the design office. Therefore, it is the responsibility of an applicant to ensure that he or she does an extensive search in proprietary databases or publicly available sources. So it is not, when you file the application, you have to take care, you have to do the search. And you can hire different search agencies, you can hire different law firms to do the search on your behalf. But if you feel at any time that your design, if you're not sure of the new or originality part of your design, you can go for this search. And as such, for design, you only have to look for images. So you can even do a quick Google search. I think Google also now has a feature where you can put up the design and you can put up a publish and search for the application. But I'm not sure how safe that is, because if the Google saves your image, then your image would become public. So, but at least you can try and search by the name and see all the images. That is one thing that anybody can do. So then again, the application for registration of design can be filed by the applicant himself or through a professional person like a patent agent. So you can leave that. And yes, however, applicants not residing in India will have to take services of an agent residing in India. So this, again, this clause is again because patent office wants an address which is inside India, where they have to courier documents, they have to courier examination reports, they have to courier your grant certificate. So it won't an address within India to which they can send something. If they want to talk to the applicant, if they give a hearing notice and they want the applicant to come up, it would of course not be very easy for the controller to call up somebody. Controller at such general does not call, but it would also not be possible for a person living outside India to say come up for a hearing within 10 days. So that's why the patent office always wants a local address in India to which they can send document. And that's why if you an applicant is not residing in India, they have to take a service of an agent. If you are able to do all these things, you are able to convince the controller or understand the objection and are able to provide some solution to the controller there, then your application will get accepted. There will be a notification in the official gazette and there will be a certificate will be issued to you. So generally what happens is after the acceptance, this first the certificate is issued, patent office signs, the controller signs the certificate of design, and once the design certificate is issued, then I think within a time period of 1 month, the application has to be published in the official gazette. So what they generally publish is the bibliographic of the design, the name, the class in which it was filed, the applicant who filed the application, and they also file one design, the design with the view which could represent the design the most clearly. So the best design out of all the best view out of all the views that you had submitted, that is published along with the design in the gazette. If somehow the patent office rejects it, then you have a chance of appealing to the court, and for that you appeal to the High Court directly. And since the design office is in Kolkata, so most probably you'll have to go to the Kolkata High Court to file an appeal against the design's office order. Now, comparison of patents, designs, and copyrights. First, yes, whenever you file the application, you can file in all the patent offices. From there, they go to Kolkata Design. Sorry? No, for design and patents, you have to go only for the four patent offices, the Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai and Kolkata, only four. These are the only four. No, Ahmedabad office as such is not a complete design and patent office. It is not a complete office. It is just a unit for trademark. And also I think they are then transmitting, I'm not sure how it works, but I think they might be transmitting the document to other main offices or not. I'm not sure about the trademark, how it works. But yes, at least for designs and patents, you have to go and file application in any of the four offices. In design office, for design, you can file the application in Kolkata. The initial, that is the only doc in any of the four patent office. That is the only document which all these offices will accept. However, after that, if you have to submit any document, say you did not submit your power of attorney at the time of filing, you did not submit the priority document, or whenever you have to submit the response to the examination of to the examination report, all those documents have to be submitted to the design patent in design office in Kolkata. The patent office in other country, in other regions would not accept any document apart from the initial filing. This is what the arrangement is as of now. They have also come up with an e-filing portal. So, but also that e-filing portal is again at present only for filing of new applications. You cannot file your responses or other documents using the e-filing portal, because that has just come up. They are working over it. They are trying to improve all the glitches in it. And once it starts working smoothly, like in case of patents, say in another year, they might start providing other functionalities also. But at present, all the things have to be submitted to Kolkata Patent Office. There are all the examiners. The controller also sits there, and hearings also take place in Kolkata office only. Now, okay, patents versus design. So patents, they are granted for a product or process. Designs are granted for features of an article. So maybe the product that you manufactured using the patent that might have a very good design, that might have a very aesthetic appeal. So you can go for the features of that article, that product in the design protection, but you can only claim the feature, only claim the aesthetic view or the design of that article. You cannot claim the way by which the design was manufactured, by the way by which the article was manufactured. For that, you'll have to go for patents. Patents, it protects the technological innovation in the product, and it protects the aesthetic appeal of the article. Say, for example, the way a cell phone works will come up under the patent protection. The way the cell phone looks comes under the design protection. It is for granted for 20 years, it is granted for 10 years, which can be further extended by a period of 5 years like we discussed. It typically takes 4 to 7 years of grant, it takes 6 months to 1 year for registration. So if you are quick, the moment you receive the examination report, you file the response within a week or two, then you can reduce the time period. This time period generally also depends on how quick you and the agent were in filing the response back to the patent office. How less the objections were? If there were less objections, if there were no formal objections. I've seen generally the examination report, they get stuck in because of some formal objections, because of something which you had used in your design, which the patent office says that a design protection cannot be protected for that. So generally on those kind of things, we have argument with the patent, with the controller, and that is how the time period extends from 6 months to 1 year. However, if there are no such problems, if your design was very clear, the views that you had submitted, they were clear, and the design was something which could have been easily captured, grant for which a design could be clearly granted, then your time period would be less than 1 year. It might come up with, you might get the grant within 6 to 8 months. Copyright versus design. Copyright subsists in expression of an idea. Design is granted for the features of an article. So copyright, you could have that Lord Ganesha's painting. If you come up with that, that might come up under copyright because that was a person's idea on how he thought Lord Ganesha would look. He would have a long trunk, long ears, how he came up. You would have seen many paintings in which Lord Ganesha is shown differently. Lord Krishna, all these gods, they are shown differently. They are all these gods, as such how they look, they are just an expression of a person's idea, how he thought they would look like. So that would come under copyright. But the design would be the particular statue that you finally build up of one of the Lord. And what the patent office would look at, not whether whose statue it is, what they would look is that it is a showpiece. It has this particular shape, it has this configuration. That is something that would be for the patent office to look at. They would not look at that whose statue it is, what article it is. They would finally look at how it looks and what are the features of that article. No registration or examination is required for copyright. So if you have a copyright, the moment you come up with that painting, you have a copyright over that. It is not necessary to have a registration. Although it is good to have a registration, because when you have a registration, you have more chances on how you can file a suit against him. But even if you have not filed a copyright for your copyright material, if you have not registered your copyright, you still have some copyright over it. You can go under law of torts for that thing. And design you. And the period of protection, it generally ends at 60 years from the death of the authors. So if a child comes up with something for which he has a copyright, then he would have a protection for, I don't know, 100 years maybe. Whereas the design, irrespective of who comes up with the design, you would have a protection for 10 years and at max 5 years, and is typically granted within a year. However, if you think that you would be manufacturing more than 50 pieces, then it's always safe to have the design protection. Because at max, when you file with the patent office, at max what the design office would say is that no, you cannot have a design. Suppose you have a doubt whether it should be protected in a design or a copyright act, and you are sure you're going to manufacture more than 50 pieces, You can file a design protection if the design office says that it is something which should be protected under Copyright Act and not Design Act. Then at least you would have some guarantee from the patent office that once you manufacture more than 50 pieces, they would not come back and say that you do not have copyright. Because in the court of law, you can say that, see, I do not have design protection over that, so at least I would have some copyright protection. So it is always safe before deciding of whether to go for designs or copyright protection, first find out whether you are going to manufacture more than 50 pieces or not. There have been a lot of cases in Delhi and Mumbai High Court where this thing became issue because the person thought that he would have a copyright, so he does not need to have a design protection, but he manufactured more than 50 pieces and he lost the cases there. So this is as such everything about designs. This is design protection in the field of agriculture. I am as such not much versed with the field of agriculture, but I tried to bring out few examples here to show what are the different things for which you might have design protection in the field of agriculture. So various tools, equipments and machines which are used in the field of agriculture can be protected under the Designs Act. It provides a list of Locarno classifications under which we can protect the designs. So like I told you, Locarno classification is again the class or the category of articles or the products which we talked about. So it says that there is class 8 and subclass 5, class 12, subclass 9, 10, 16, class 15 and subclass 3. So we'll see. So for example, if this class 8 broadly talks about all tools and hardware, and the subclass within this class, it says that other tools and implements, and for example, agricultural rollers or hand operated. This is actually something not given in the Act, but this is what we have come up across in the field. And so these are few of the examples of what designs have been granted in this class and subclass. So a rake, manually operated agricultural pump, spray gun. So if you have these things, you can go for a design protection. There couldn't be other examples also. These are for just few examples which I came up with. Means of transport or hoisting. It can include all kinds of transports, but it has a specific class which talks about tractors. So in the whole this tractor, you can have this whole tractor, or you can have a design protection for only the tractor cab. See, it is this part only, but they had filed two different design applications because they want to catch anybody who comes up with this final product also and somebody who manufactures this also. You might have a design protection for, say, this. You might have a design protection for this also separately, right? So if you are into this field, this is something. Road wheel trailers, for example, trolley or trailer. I think these are for taking up, for carrying material or for carrying the final product from the field. So these are something you can have a design protection over that. They both are almost, I think, for the similar kind of things, but they have different designs. You can have different designs for the same thing. Parts, equipment, and accessories for vehicles not included in other classes of subclasses. So you can have plow. This was for a car, but I just thought that something. And wheel rim for a vehicle. This is also something. So for a tractor, you might have a wheel rim. And if it is not protected under tractor as such, you can try to protect it under the accessories for a vehicle. Agricultural machine. Machines not elsewhere specified. And they mention subclass 3 agricultural machinery. Examples are these. All these are examples. The stone removing machine, husk separator, weed remover. So it is not only that a person, so any, even in field of agriculture, you have so much protection, so much scope of protection under designs also. It's not only going to be chemical industry. It is not only going to be patents on how this machine work. It also depends on how the machine look. So I think weed remover is something which would have been known to everyone. You would have a lot of technology on these, but the way one weed remover looks and how it differs from the other weed remover, that is something which you can protect. Thank you.